I was born in Cojuco on the plantation in Cojuco Hospital. And at the age of 12 years old, yeah, I started surfing down in Laia. And there's a place called Castles, and they call it Castles because the richer people from town own nice beach houses there. And so the locals called it Castles because the homes were so beautiful, yeah. '15 or '16, we started surfing Belzeland, started venturing down the coast, yeah. This is the first picture I ever got of myself. My brother took this picture, that's Belzeland, and by myself too, that day. You know, I used to be able to surf Belzeland constantly by myself, Pipeline by myself, Haleiwa. Waimea, I never surfed by myself, but we used to surf it pretty uncrowded. This is Pipeline on a small day, but nobody around. My God. During the week, nobody would be surfing the North Shore, so anytime it got good, I'd drive down there and paddle out. And yeah, I've surfed many times at Pipe by myself. On good, you know, good 10-foot days, double overhead days. Jerry Bloomfield. This is pretty funny. When I was a junior and senior, I commuted to town. Prior to that, I was boarding at Kamehameha. But I commuted to this school, Kamehameha School, and so I could surf in the afternoons, and I would come to Haleiwa, it'd be perfect, you know, perfect 6, 8 feet, whatever. And nobody out, nobody out. And would surf, yeah, amazing, amazing. Another gem in my life was living at Covela Bay. My parents had a, were fortunate enough to buy a cottage there, although it wasn't fee simple, they didn't own the land. But so we all got to be, we all, my siblings and my cousins and friends, got to have a part, you know, Covela was part of our life. Our front yard was the ocean, beautiful bay. And nobody around because there are cottages down there, but mostly people from town own them, and they just come out during the weekend, yeah? So during the week, it's like you have this whole area. It's just awesome. Anyway, all these days, this is me, this is me, this is Buddy Boy. Ka'ohi, I think. Ka'ohi, yeah. Buddy Boy, man, he was, I met him in town. He was one of our Ala Moana crew. He was a rascal, but oh, what a beautiful surfer. We had to move out of Covela in 87 because they were gonna build a hotel there and stuff. And we had to move out of there. And it was like, it was a total, you know, lifestyle change for us. I went to Bali once, and with Tommy Nellis and his group, yeah, and I caught one of the longest, most beautiful lefts there at Uluwatu of all places. And anyway, this thing just beautiful. But the week I came back, I caught one down here, just as big, just as long, and I was going, man, I don't have to go anywhere. This, you know, I got. Perfect waves right here in my backyard, man. I look at these pictures and I remember again how much I love surfing. It makes me long for it again. This is Pipeline, and I was only one out this day too. Yeah, yeah. Look at this. This is classic. Look at that. Showing at. Oh, this one's Kailua, but they showed it here at Wailua High School. I think Lopez said it's a cakewalk, you know. All you have to do is set yourself up, and it's just the wave does the surfing. It's amazing. But this is the kind of day I'm talking about. Beautiful pipeline, perfect. The wave surfs for you over there, man. I'm 67 today, yeah. So that was 60, I was 60, 61. I was 62, 63. I was surfing pipeline a lot. Yeah, man, I appreciate you doing this. I really do. That's cool.